And now for the next mission of our food adventure.
Spaghetti, it's my favorite. Oh, yeah.
What's wrong, JJ?
I don't know how to eat spaghetti with a fork. I can't be in the adventure with you anymore.
Oh, sure. If you've never eaten spaghetti with a fork before, that could be a little confusing.
It is confusing.
It's okay to be confused about how to do something you've never done.
We'll teach you. We're on this adventure together. Yay!
The spaghetti doesn't like my fork. It keeps slipping through. And it's kind of messy no matter what I do. We're on a food adventure. Don't worry, we'll help you. Just twirl and twirl and twirl, then chew and chew and chew.
You make it look so easy.
Don't give up,
just stick to it.
We all had to learn how to do it. When you're ready for spaghetti, twirl your fork round and round. When you're ready for spaghetti, twirl around, it's ready to slurp.
I'll try again, but I don't know if I can do it. Oops!
The spaghetti still slipped off my fork. I just want a bite. I was twirling like you showed me.
When will I get it right?
Spaghetti can be tricky. Just try a little more. I had lots of practice. Now my fork lion roars, roar!
It's squirmy. Maybe I can try it a different way.
Don't give up,
just stick to it.
We all had to learn how to do it. When you're ready for spaghetti, twirl your fork round and round. When you're ready for spaghetti, twirl around, it's ready to slurp.
It wiggled away, but I'll try again.
I tried and tried and tried, but I'm not giving up. Watch, I'm twirling my fork again. Can I slurp, slurp, slurp it up?
I did it!
Great job!
That's awesome!
When you're ready for spaghetti, twirl your fork round and round. When you're ready for spaghetti, twirl around, it's ready to slurp. Twirl around, it's ready to slurp.
Oops, excuse me.
This car ride. I haven't seen any cows, dinosaurs, or spaceships. And I finished my sippy cup. Are we there yet?
Oh, not yet. It's gonna be a little longer, sweetie.
I feel all wiggly.
It's normal to feel that way. We're all feeling a little impatient.
Impatient?
Sure. We feel impatient sometimes when we want something to happen right now, but it can't.
But whenever we feel impatient, we can find fun things to do to pass the time.
Like what?
There's lots that we can do when traveling feels long. Like we could play a game, or we could sing a song. We're driving, driving. Doesn't matter where we are, as long as we have lots of fun inside the car.
Are we there yet?
Not yet.
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 Ooh, now I'm hungry too.
When you're little tummy growls, well, that's what snacks are for. and you can chomp them up just like a dinosaur.
We're driving, driving, it doesn't matter where we are, as long as we have lots of snacks inside the car.
Are we there yet?
Not yet.
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 I know. Let's play a game. Look for something blue.
Yeah.
What do you see?
A car.
What do you see?
The sky.
What do you see?
A bird.
What do you see?
A spaceship? What do you see, Daddy?
A dinosaur. When we've sung every song and ate the snacks we brought, it's time to take a break and make a party stop.
I'm searching, searching, searching near and searching far. I'm so happy finding blue outside the car.
We're driving, driving, it doesn't matter where we are. I'm so happy with my family in the car. I'm so happy with my family in the car.
Are you okay?
I don't think I can get in. It's too big and scary.
It's okay to feel scared, but Miss Appleberry will make sure you stay safe.
That's right, Cece.
But there's no bubbles or dolphins or fishy friends.
That's true. We don't have any dolphins or bubbles, but would it help if you could have a fish friend?
Hi, fishy friend. I guess it does help a little.
You don't have to go in all at once, but maybe you can try taking it one step at a time.
Take one step at a time, one teeny tiny step.
But the water feels cold, like shivers on my skin. My toes feel so chilly. Do I have to go in?
Take one step at a time, one teeny tiny step. Just one step, you'll be fine. It helps you get to what comes next. Just wiggle your toes around and around.
I think I feel them warming up now.
Take one step at a time, one step at a time.
The pool is so deep. Will it reach up to my chin? Looks way deeper than the tub. Do I have to jump in?
Take one step at a time, one teeny tiny step. Just one step, you'll be fine. It helps you get to what comes next. Your head will stay nice and dry, you'll see.
So I'm taller than the water will be?
Yep. Take one step at
try.
good of you, sweetie.
Go, Cece.
Thanks for showing me how, Miss Appleberry. And thanks for letting me catch you, Wall.
Sisters.
Aw, Mija.
It's okay to feel a little frustrated.
What's frustrated?
Frustrated is when you're mad or upset that something isn't going the way you want.
Yes, I'm very frustrated.
It's okay to feel that way. I didn't know how to tie my shoes at first, but now I can. I can show you the way I learned.
Okay. What if it's too hard to tie my shoe? Some things can be hard when they are new. Maybe I can try it. I'll take a shoe and tie it. Then I'll have cool shoes just like you.
Watch me, sis. First I take a lace in each hand. Next I supernova, pull tight and I make two loops. I super. Wanna try?
I wish I could tie these, I'm not sure though. I know it takes practice to make a bow.
Go ahead and try it, just take a shoe and tie it. Soon you'll be a tying pro. Go ahead, try again.
First I take a lace in each hand. Next I swoop one over, pull tight end. Soup, and now I've tied my shoes. Yes, I know how. Loop, swoop, and pull.
Now try the other shoe.
I know I can tie this. Yes, I know how.
Go on, see, sip, whether you can do it now.
Watch, I'm gonna try it. I'll take a shoe and tie it. Soon you will see, then you'll say, wow. Take a lace in each hand. Next I swoop one over, pull tight end. I make two loops, I swoop and now I've tied my shoes. Yes, I know how. First I take a lace in each hand. Next I swoop one over, pull tight end. I make two loops, I swoop and
for not giving up. And next time you have trouble tying your shoes, just sing the song.
Hey, Bud. Why don't I put Cece's gift with the other gifts?
I don't want to put Bolly down. Bolly is so fun and sparkly, and I even gave him a name. I wish Bolly was my birthday present.
I wonder if you're feeling jealous, Bud. That's when you want something that's someone else's.
Yeah, I guess I am jealous.
I get that. And it's okay to feel that way. But you still need to give the present to Cece. How does Bolly make you feel?
Bolly makes me so happy.
Well, maybe Bolly will make Cece feel happy too. I know how much you love making people feel happy. You'll see. Giving feels great.
I love this present for Cece. I wish that it was mine.
I know you want to keep it, but this is giving time.
And you know giving feels good.
Giving a present makes friends smile. It's a nice thing to do. You'll make someone very happy, and you'll feel happy too. giving a present makes friends smile. It's a nice thing to do. You'll make someone very happy, and you'll feel happy too.
I like to make people happy, but I'll miss Molly. Giving up a present isn't easy. I don't want the fun to end.
The fun will keep on going when you give to a friend.
She would love it, but...
Giving a present makes friends smile. It's a nice thing to do. You'll make someone very happy, and you'll feel happy too. Giving a present makes friends smile. It's a nice thing to do. You'll make someone very happy, and you'll feel happy too.
I do like making people smile.
Giving gifts is so much fun, but it's sometimes hard to do.
I like to make people happy. It makes me happy too. I got it! So when I give the gift to Cece, she'll feel super happy too. Happy birthday, Cece!
Thank you, Nico. I love it!
Wow! It wasn't hard at all. Cece loved it, and I loved it too.
Giving a present makes friends smile. It was a nice thing to do. I made someone very happy, so I'd feel happy too. Giving a present makes friends smile. It was a nice thing to do.
I'm so proud of you for giving Cece that ball. See how happy you made her?
Uh-huh. Giving feels great.